What is going on, guys? I'm playing with the new Beretta M1938 PG today. It was this week's Tides of War weapon to unlock. This is another assault class weapon that falls under the assault rifle category. And I can tell you already, this gun is insanely good on the battlefield, and I think will instantly be a popular weapon as well. It has the highest damage output out of all the assault rifle weapons so far. Now, the stats show this only a slight improvement, but in reality, you really feel the damage being dealt when using this gun. It's an absolute monster to be using. It also has a pretty cool burst round fire with the weapon, which makes it really fun to use. It's a little bit different of gunplay style than the other assault rifle. So it's a little bit different getting used to, but once you get into rhythm with the burst fire, it's an extremely fun gun to be using. It has some pretty nice accuracy as well. It's not going to compete accuracy wise with the Ribiolis, but definitely beats out other guns like the Sturmgewehr and the M1907SF, putting its accuracy more on par with the STG-44. Its hipfire stock, it's the same as the rest of the assault rifles, and its control falls again somewhere in the middle of all these weapons. What's really cool about this gun is trying out some of the new specializations that we haven't seen before in the assault rifle category. We have specializations like the trigger job that will decrease the time between bursts, increasing the rate of fire from 423 to 540. This definitely helps bring the gun up from being the slowest rate of fire out of all the assault rifles to tied for last with the Ribiolis. You definitely notice the difference in speed when you have the specialization equipped, and it just feels like a beast with the rapid burst fire that you have. Not to mention how devastating it is against enemy players with additional damage. So just the combination of the increased rate of fire with the damage just makes this gun a monster to use. Now, you might think because of its slow rate of fire, you'd want to stick to the right side of the specialization list. But you'd be surprised just how good the light bolt is as well. This specialization decreases the time between shots of a single burst, not between bursts, which is what the trigger job does. So if you have this one equipped, you can really do damage with the specialization as well. And you can do the option of going single fire mode with this gun, which is surprisingly not all too bad for being an assault rifle and putting shots on players just from tap firing the trigger. Again, I can't say enough how good the extra damage for this gun and how it really stands out. And it's the only assault rifle weapon that I feel like bridges the gap between the assault rifles and the semi-automatic rifles, who have always just had better damage than the assault weapons in the past. And even though the Beretta's damage isn't going to come close to the Gewehr 43 or the Turner SMLE, it does tie guns like the M1A1 carbine with its damage output, while as well beating it out in its rate of fire, given that you have one of the two previous specializations that I have mentioned that increase the rate of fire for your gun equipped. So when it came to choosing specializations for this gun, I went ahead with the quick aim and then had equipped the ported barrel, which gives you a little bit more accuracy by giving the gun a little bit less horizontal recoil. Then went ahead and equipped the trigger job, and finally chose the custom stock, which improves accuracy while moving, since I feel like I can actually play a little bit aggressive with this weapon despite it having a pretty slow rate of fire. You can also choose the barrel bedding, which will increase your accuracy while stationary if you choose to play a little bit less aggressive. But overall, this gun is definitely refreshing the experience on the battlefield, and again, I think it would be a very popular gun to be used. It does have some downsides, of course. Like I made mention earlier, it is the slowest out of all the assault rifles with its rate of fire stock. So equipping those specializations will help a bit, whether you equip the trigger job or choose the light bolt. But even with those specializations equipped, it's still going to be a pretty slow assault rifle regardless. So you can also feel at times the control of this gun. It's not terrible, but you do feel it at times. And finally, it only has a 20 round magazine, making it another thing that it places last on in the assault rifle category. So you'll probably end up noticing the smaller magazine size than the control, but I would say with its rate of fire and its magazine size are probably going to be the two major downfalls for this gun. So the more you take advantage of the higher damage output and the accuracy, getting as many headshots as you can on enemy players will go a very long way with this new weapon. But that's my quick review on the Beretta M1935 PG. I can't praise this gun enough of how really fun it is on the battlefield. So if you have had a chance to hop on and try this gun out, I suggest doing it as quick as you can, because it is definitely a pretty fun gun to be using. But feel free to let me know what you guys think about this new weapon in the comments down below. But that is it for you guys today. Again, I always appreciate you guys being here. I am Livin', and I'll catch you guys again later.